It's my great pleasure to introduce Colin Herbert tonight. I'm really looking forward to this talk about his great uncle Ernest's letters that have been sent from the First World War on the battle lines of the trenches, and it's a wonderful insight into how those poor soldiers had to survive those terrible conditions, but with a bit of humour as well, I think. The letters reveal some of that humour to us. So I hope you enjoy the talk tonight, and I know I'm looking forward to it. So thank you very much, Colin.
Thank you for coming. Just over 2 weeks ago, I was talking to a women's institute somewhere in Cheshire. I won't tell you exactly where it was. And their chairman had given a very pleasant introduction, and I was standing behind my lectern, ready to go with letter number one, and suddenly she said, "Awfully sorry, Mr. Herbert, we've forgotten to sing Jerusalem." There was I behind, on my own, out in front here, knowing about 47.36% of the words of Jerusalem. I had to mouth the rest of them. And I'm delighted you didn't ask me to break into song with the Welsh National Anthem or something this evening. Right, we're going to talk this evening about the adventures of Great Uncle Ernest. Some of you are gluttons for punishment. There's one person here who has heard it, I think, three times in various organisations. Most of you will have not heard it at all. And there's somebody very special to me that hasn't heard it before. And Annabelle tells me that she's going to count the number of ums and ers, and when I get home later tonight, she'll tell me off. So this is your first time. I hope you enjoy it, my love. Each one of you, I guarantee, has a great Uncle Ernest. You've got a drawer somewhere at home, where there'll be a medal, there'll be a letter, a photograph, something about somebody in the Great War. It may be a grandfather, it may be a father. We've all got that great Uncle Ernest. And this evening I'm going to share with you some of the letters that great Uncle Ernest, and he was a real great uncle, he was my mother's half-sister's uncle. Not a blood relation, but I can genuinely claim him as a relation, so great Uncle Ernest. These letters that he wrote home were found in the loft of a house at Enfield, North London, in the late 1990s. My relations who lived in that house were moving. They'd been to the loft many times, meaning clearing everything out. They found right at the back of the loft, underneath the slope of the roof and the floor of the loft, they saw a shoebox. And lo and behold, in that shoebox were 76 handwritten letters, they didn't know they were there, from Great Uncle Ernest. And a cousin of mine has the original letters, and he knew my interest in the Great War, and he said about 8-9 years ago, "Colin, you better have these letters, they make fascinating reading." And the copies have come into my possession, and the copies I'm going to dip in and out. I'm not going to read you, I promise, 76 letters. That would be very boring. But dip into letters and let you know some of the things that he was thinking about, writing about in the Great War. He was one of a very large family. He was one of 9 children. He had 7 sisters, and a brother, and his mother had died, sadly, or their mother had died, and before the war he lived with his father in this house in Wood Green, North London, and when war was declared, Ernest was working for the Imperial Ottoman Bank. He was a junior manager in the bank. He'd been born in 1889, so he was a junior manager in the bank, and when war was declared, like many other young lads, he joined up. And because he'd got some qualifications from school, because he was quite a bright lad, he joined an organisation called the Artist Rifles. And the Artist Rifles was an organisation for potential officers, those who had got a bit something about them, a bit of spark about them. They'd got their basic educational qualifications. He was on the route to becoming an officer, to getting a pip on each shoulder. The first letter that Ernest writes home is in fact the 3rd of January 1915. He's been doing basic training in the UK and he's off to France for the first time. And he says in this letter that we left Southampton on Tuesday at about 4 o'clock, embarking in an old cattle boat which had been converted to take the horses of the cavalry. And those of you